Good afternoon, students. So in the last class we have solved up to the 20th problem. So in today's class let us continue with the 21st problems. So usually these problems are little bit lengthy. You need to be very good at simplification to get the accurate answer. So let us go ahead with the 21st question. So this is in the form of px plus q divided by square root of ax square plus bx plus c dx. So let me take this as I which is equal to integral x plus 2 divided by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. So now this can be written as x plus 2 which is equal to a into d by dx of the quadratic polynomial, a into d by dx of x square plus 2x plus 3 plus b. So now x plus 2 which is equal to a, I write it as it is. Then we have to differentiate this quadratic polynomial. So derivative of x square will be 2x plus 2x will be 2, and then derivative of 3 will be 0, that I have not written, plus b. So I call this as equation number 1. Next we have to multiply a with these two terms. So x plus 2 which is equal to 2ax plus 2a plus b. So now we have to find the value of a and b. In order to find those two values, we have to go for equating the coefficient of x and the constant of both the sides. So in the RHS, what is the coefficient of x? It is 2a. So what about in the LHS? The coefficient of x, it is 1. So I can equate 2a with 1. So 2a equal to 1. What about a now? It is 1 by 2. So a value, it is 1 by 2. Next we will have to calculate b value. So now we have to equate the constant terms both the sides. So here the constant term, it is 2a plus b. So 2a plus b is a constant term. And then here in the LHS, 2 is the constant term. So 2a plus b which is equals to 2. So in place of a, I can write 1 by 2. So 2 times 1 by 2 plus b which is equals to 2. So 2 get cancelled. We have 1 now. Take 1 to the RHS, becomes minus 1. 2 minus 1 will be 1. B which is equals to 2 minus 1 which is equals to 1. We have got the value of A as well as B. Next we have to substitute those two values in equation number 1. So here equation 1 becomes x plus 2 which is equals to a into 2x plus 2. A value, it is 1 by 2. So I write 1 by 2 into the bracket 2x plus 2 plus b, that is 1. The value of b, it is 1. So now both the sides we have to divide by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3. So let us go ahead with that step now. X plus 2 divided by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 which is equal to 1 by 2 into 2x plus 2 divided by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 plus 1 divided by square root of plus 1 divided by plus 1 divided by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3. So now I can integrate both the sides with respect to x. So let us go for the integrating LHS as well as RHS. So this becomes integral dx. So now I take the LHS as I, capital R. So I which is equal to 1 by 2 times I1 plus plus I2, 1 by 2 times I1 plus I2. Call this as equation number 2. Next, we have to find I1 and I2. So, let me go with the I1. Now, I1 which is equals to integral. So, I take this as I1 now. This integral is I1 now. x plus 2 plus 2 divided by square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. So now this is in the standard form now. Integration of f dash of x by square root of f of x dx. So that is the case. The answer will be 2 times root f of x plus c. Or you can solve by the conventional method. That is, take this as t. So put x square plus 2x plus 3. This is equals to t. Differentiate both the sides now. We get 2x plus 2 dx, which is equals to dt. So what is the 2x plus 2 dx? It is dt. So rewrite I1. I1 which is equals to integral dt by root t. So what is integration of dt by root t? It is 2 times root t plus c1. I1 which is equals to 2 times root t plus c1. This is equals to. So 2 times root t. It is x square plus 2x plus 3. X square plus 2x plus 3 plus c1. Call this as equation number 3. Next, we have to find I2 and then later substitute I1 and I2 in equation number 2 to get the final value of I. So, we have calculated I1. Let me go with the I2. I2 which is equals to integral dx upon square root of x square plus 2x plus 3. So here the integral in the denominator involves the quadratic polynomial, and we have to solve this by completing the square method. So let us take the polynomial x square plus 2x plus 3, which is equals to x square plus 2x plus 3. Now we have to add and subtract 1 by 2 into b the whole square. So I take 1 by 2 into b. What is the value of b? It is 2. The value of b, it is 2 here. The whole square. So 2 get cancels. We have 1. 1 square will be 1. So we have to add and subtract 1. Plus 1, then minus 1. See here, we have a square plus 2ab, we need b square now. So that is why I group these two and then 1. So here, these three together can be written as x plus 1 the whole square, and then 3 minus 1 will give us 2. Then in the next step, we can write this as x plus 1 the whole square plus root 2 the whole square. So now we can replace this quadratic polynomial by the standard form. Therefore, I2 which is equals to integral dx upon square root of x plus 1 the whole square plus root 2 the whole square. Root 2 the whole square and complete the square root. So this is in the form of integration dx by x square plus a square. So I2 which is equal to log mod x. What is x now? It is x plus 1. So x plus 1 plus square root of x square plus a square, that is x plus 1 the whole square plus plus root 2 the square, root 2 the square part of it plus C2. So I2 which is equals to log mod x plus 1 plus square root of x plus 1 the whole square plus root 2 the square. This can be written as x square plus 2x plus 3. So I am substituting back. So it is x square plus 2x plus 3 mod complete plus C2. So I call this as equation number 4. Now we have to substitute 3 and 4 in equation number 2 to get the value of I. Put 3 and 4 in 2. So now I which is equals to, so here 1 by 2 will be multiplied with I1. So 1 by 2 into I1 is this equation now, equation number 3. X square plus 2x plus 3 plus 2 times C1 plus 2 times C1, or you can write C1. Anyway, you are going to replace a constant by some other constant. Then plus, it is I2. So we have the I2 here. So that I will write below. Log, mod x plus 1 plus square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 plus C2. So now here 2 and 2 get cancels. I write the final value of the integral. It is square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 plus log mod x plus 1 plus square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 plus C, where C which is equals to, where C which is equals to 2C1 plus C2, 2C1 plus C2. So this is all about the 21st problem. So pause the video to note it down. Well, the 22nd question, it is integral x plus 3 divided by x square minus 2x minus 5 dx. So again, this is in the standard form of integration of px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus c. So let me write this as I. I which is equals to integral, x plus 3 divided by x square minus 2x then minus 5. So I go for the standard form now. It is x plus 3, this is equals to a times d by dx of the denominator, that is x square minus 2x minus 5. X square minus 2x minus 5 plus b. So now x plus 3 I write it as it is, which is equals to a. Now the derivative of this quadratic polynomial, so what do we get now? 2x minus 2 plus b. Call this as equation number 1. So now multiply a with these two terms, x plus 3. The next step will be x plus 3 which is equals to 2ax minus a into 2, it is 2a, plus b. Now, we have to equate the coefficient of x and the constant terms both the sides. So in the RHS, the coefficient of x it is 2a. So what about the coefficient of x in the left hand side? It is 1. Therefore, I can equate, 2a which is equals to 1. So now a which is equals to 1 divided by 2. So we have the value of a now. Next we have to go for equating the constant term with the constant. So minus 2a plus b is a constant.
So now in the LHS, 3 is a constant term. So let us equate this now. Minus 2a plus b, which is equals to 3. In case there is no constant in the left hand side, we have to equate the constant term with 0. Keep this in mind. So now minus 2 I write as it is. The value of a it is 1 by 2 plus b, which is equals to 3. So 2 get cancels. We have the minus 1. Take minus 1 to the RHS, it becomes plus 1. So b, which is equals to 3 plus 1, which is 4. So we have got the value of a and b. Let us substitute these two values in equation number 1. So equation 1 becomes x plus 3, which is equals to a, it is 1 by 2, so I write 1 by 2, then into 2x minus 2 plus b value it is 4, so I write 4 here, plus 4. Now both the sides we have to divide by the denominator of the integrand. It is x square minus 2x minus 5. So let us divide this now. X plus 3 divided by x square minus 2x minus 5, which is equals to 1 by 2. And then it is equals to 1 by 2. Then 2x minus 2 divided by x square divided by x square minus 2x minus 5, and then plus 4 divided by plus 4 into 1 divided by x square minus 2x minus 5. So both the sides we can integrate with respect to x. So here integration dx. Then here integral dx. Then here integral dx. So now I take this as I. So I, which is equals to 1 by 2 times I1 plus 4 times I2. I call this as equation number 2. Now we have to find I1 and I2. So I take I1 now. Now I1, which is equals to, so this will be our I1. This will be our I1. So integral 2x minus 2 divided by x square minus 2x minus 5 dx. So now observe the numerator and the denominator. It is in the form of integration of f dash of x by f of x dx. So if that is the case, the answer will be log mod f of x plus c, or solve this by the convention method. Let us take the denominator as t. Put x square minus 2x minus 5, which is equals to t. Now differentiate both the sides with respect to x. So we get 2x minus 2 dx, which is equals to dt. So I rewrite I1 now. I1, which is equals to integral, so dt upon t. So what is integral dt upon t? I1, which is equals to log mod t plus c1, which is equals to, now replace t here. So log mod, what is t? It is x square minus 2x minus 5. X square minus 2x minus 5 plus c1. I call this as equation number 3. So since we do not have much space, so pause the video to note it down, then we go for calculating I2. Well, so far we have calculated I1. Now we want to calculate I2. So let us go ahead with the I2. And I2, which is equals to integral dx upon dx upon x square minus 2x minus 5. So now we have to solve this by completing the square bracket. So let us take up only the quadratic polynomial x square minus 2x minus 5, which is equals to. So for this term, we need to add and subtract 1 by 2 into b the whole square. So I write this as it is, x square minus 2x minus 5. Let us go for 1 by 2 into b. 1 by 2 into b. What is the value of b here? It is minus 2. So minus 2 the whole square. 1 by 2 into b the whole square. 2 to get cancels. We have the minus 1. Minus 1 square will be plus 1. So let us add and subtract 1. Add and subtract 1 here. So I write plus 1 and then minus 1. So now see here. It is in the form of a square minus 2ab. So a square minus 2ab means it has to be in the form of a minus b the whole square. So I group these two along with this one. So x square minus 2x plus 1. Then minus 5 minus 1 will give us minus 6. So how do you write these three now? It can be written as x minus 1 the whole square, then minus 6 can be written as root 6 the whole square. Root 6 the whole square. So now we have to replace this quadratic polynomial by the standard known form. So I2 this is equals to integral dx upon x minus 1 the whole square, then minus root 6 the whole square. X minus 1 the whole square minus root 6 the whole square. So now this is in the form of integration dx by x square minus a square. So that will be 1 by 2a log mod x minus a divided by x plus a plus c. I2 which is equals to 1 by 2a, 1 divided by 2a. What is a here? It is root 6 log mod x minus, here x is nothing but x minus 1. In place of x, we have x minus 1. X minus a, it is minus root 6 divided by x plus a divided by x plus a plus c2. So now see here, I2 which is we have got I2. I call this as equation number 4. This as equation number 4. Now substitute equation 3 and equation 4 in equation number 2. 4. 3 and 4 in 2. In 2. So let us substitute in I which is equals to, so we have 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 will be multiplied with I1. We have the I1 here. So it is log mod x square minus 2x minus 5. And then 1 by 2 will be multiplied with c1, or you can write c1 itself. So we get 1 by 2 into c1 will be c1 by 2. C1 by 2 plus 4 times, see here, 4 times I2. So I write that term here, 4 times 1 by 2 root 6 into log mod x minus 1 minus root 6 divided by x minus 1 plus root 6 plus 4 times c2. So see here, 2 ones are 2, 2 sir. So I which is equals to 1 by 2 log mod x square minus 2x minus 5 plus 2 into 1 it is 2. So we get 2 divided by root 6 into log mod. So we write x minus 1 minus root 6 divided by x minus 1 plus root 6 plus c, where c, which is equals to, what is c now? It is c1 by 2 plus 4 times c2. C1 by 2 plus 4 times c2. So this is the final answer for the 22nd problem. So pause the video to note it down.